What is going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. Today we want to talk about the Monstera Deliciosa once again. Well, what happened? Did it go contaminated? Did it die? Or is growing fine? Well, kind of a mix of everything. So last time on my last update, which was kind of a while ago, I moved the plant. I re-sterilized the plant because it got contaminated with some fungus, some bacteria. And then I divided the plant in three. So I had like the roots, the part of the main plant, and then the other shoots that it was growing. So what happened? So the roots, they die, fully die. And then they got contaminated, and you can see the media is even yellow. So it's not good at all. And so this is it's gone to the trash. Then we have the main plant, or what it used to be the main plant, and this is how it looks now. It doesn't look good at all. Some of the part of the plant is still green, but it doesn't do anything. It does have quite a lot of bacteria growing as well. So I'm probably just going to throw this away as well. So to the trash. All right, so the last one, which was the shoot. So this, the good news is that yes, it's alive. Actually, it's doing all right. It has two shoots. So we have one shoot. It has now two shoots. It does have a little bit of bacteria, which is always the issue with the Monstera Deliciosa. You always get bacteria, and I use PPM, and it does control it on the most part. If I don't use PPM, it just goes out of control. So I just want to, so now what is happening? It's been 9 months. I started the Monstera Deliciosa back in September of last year, and it's been 9 months since we started. I have two plants. I mean, some of the other plants have died over the process where they got contaminated. But 9 months and it's only been two plants. So that's why it's important to always have patience, because not always going to work. It's like you set a goal. Like I set a goal myself to have 1,000 plants by the end of this year of 2021. And I don't know if we want to hit it. I mean, we still have pretty much 6 full months, but it's going to be tough. Especially right now that we only have two plants. It's just not doing well. I'm not giving up. As contrary to you see on the title or the thumbnail, I'm not giving up with this plant. I want to move it to new media. Now, if my last update, I also say that I actually messed up the media. I placed the plant in the wrong media. I used the 1 milliliter per liter of BA and 0.3 milliliters per liter of NAA. And that was not the media I was meant to use. I wanted to use the 5 milliliters per liter of BA and 0.3 milliliters per liter of NAA. So we still have some multiplication. It used that the plant hasn't really grown at all. So I want to try something different now. I want to place this in half MS media instead of the full MS. Every time this plant has always been in full MS media, and it's just not doing well. So I just want to reduce it to half MS and see if it does better. I mean, some plants doesn't like full strength MS media. For example, the carnivorous plants and the aquatic plants, they don't like full MS media. It's just too strong for them. They don't do well, or they just die. It may be the case for the Monstera Deliciosa, who knows? So I just want to try to reduce the amount of MS and see if it does better. So I just want to make some media, and I will see you in a moment. Let's get started. So I only want to make 1/4 liter for this. I don't need the full liter of media. So 250 milliliters of water. Half MS media, half MS media, but full sugars and vitamins. That goes in there. Have my pipette set to 250, so that means every one I do is equivalent to 1 milliliter per liter. So let's add ppm. I want to do 1 milliliter. Actually, I want to do 2 milliliters per liter because I have quite a lot of bacteria in there. So, trash. Grab a new tip. Let's do. I'm doing something different. This time I'm not doing BA, I'm doing TDC. I'll see if it works better than the BA. TDC is stronger than the BA. So I want to do 3 milliliters per liter. So there is one. Two. And three. Trash. Now, NAA, I want to do, let's see, how I do this? I may need another pipette. Let's see, so this is 0.1 milliliter per liter. That's two. This is, all right, so now I have it set to 0.3 milliliters per liter of NAA. And I should use the smaller pipette. This is too small to use to use the 1000 micros pipette. I should use the small one, but I just want to use this one. So as you can see, it's a very small amount. There it goes. Alright, it goes to the trash. Now let's calibrate the pH. Let me grab the other tip. Got the sodium hydroxide ready. I already know the pH is going to be close to 4.8 or something, very close to that amount. Let's see. So we are at 4.95. It's actually higher than normal, usually around 4.8. But still, you always, every time you make media, you always have to go up. If for some reason you have your pH over 6, there is something wrong there. So let's add the sodium hydroxide to increase the pH. Just one drop. I'm on 5.4. Want to add one more. 5.5, 5.6, 5.7. I like to stay between 5.4 and 5.8. Ideally, I usually stay around 5.6. So I'm at 5.7 right now, which is good enough for me. I think that's an okay. Alrighty, so 5.7, this is trash. Now the last thing I'm going to do, because I have a lot of media laying around for other plants, I want to use some food coloring just so I can distinguish what media is for. So I just want to do one drop. There you go, doesn't need that much. All right, now I need to add the, I guess every time I have worked with Monstera Deliciosa, I've been using Gelling Gum. I want to switch it and use agar for this time. If I can find it, let me see. Gelling Gum. Here is agar. So I have a quarter of a liter or 250 milliliters. So I need, if 1 liter is 6 to 10 milligrams per liter, then I need I need one quarter of that, which my math is failing me right now. All right, I think I just want to do like something like 1.5 to 2 grams. That should give me good range. All right, there we go. We have a 2 grams of agar, which because it's a quarter, that means that's equivalent to 8 grams per liter of agar. There it goes. And that's pretty much everything. That's all we need. And now we need to put that into our daily containers. And because it's a very small amount, you can just pour it in. You do that quick enough, or you can use something like this. So I think I just want to use this. Just to have equal amounts. Just put the lids on and we are ready to sterilize this media. Not because it's only two, I want to use the microwave instead. I'm not going to use the pressure cooker. So I will see you in a bit, and we are going to move the plant to this new media. All right, the media is ready, so it's time to move the Monstera Deliciosa. Oh, like my mask. Let's get started. All right, so the plants are in the new media. So we have half MS media, 3 milliliters per liter of TDC, and 0.3 milliliters per liter of NAA. I hope they do better on this media. They did have some bacteria on it. So hopefully the PPM can control some of that. And, it's also 2 milliliters per liter of PPM. And also agar. Actually, the agar was quite solid. I did equivalent to 8 grams per liter, and it was fairly solid, so I mean it's okay. Next time I may reduce it to 6 grams per liter, but we have two plants. Hopefully we can get more soon. Like I say, it's been 9 months and only two plants, so it doesn't look good at all, but I mean it is something that happens in tissue culture where you had to have patience. You want to start a business and you set your goal very high, and then sometimes you just get demolished where nothing really happens for a long time. So, I know some people say, I get some emails where people ask me like, okay, I need to propagate 1,000 plants of whatever plant. And it's like, I have like 2 months. That's like that no way you're going to hit that goal. Or I need 10,000 plants of whatever plant, I have 6 months. It is possible, but it is very hard, especially you starting from nothing. It is difficult. As you get more practice and as you get more plants growing, you should be able to hit your goals faster. But if you are just starting doing tissue culture and you set goals like I need 10,000 plants in 6 months or 1 year, it may not happen. You need to be aware of that. It can happen, but most of the times it's difficult, especially you're working with very slow growing plants. You're growing with very fast growing plants. Yes, it's very easy to do that, but some of these philodendrons and monstera, some of the aroids on the house plants are slower to grow, and then they take more time. So you need to take that in consideration. And if you want to start into tissue culture, start small, and then as you keep growing, just invest and having more materials. But I recommend to start slow and then keep growing until you feel comfortable where, okay, and this is a good business and I can keep going. So all right, I hope you have enjoyed, and I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.
Hey everyone, thanks for watching the video. If you're enjoying these tissue culture videos, be sure to follow us on social media for more informative content. And if you're interested in conducting your own tissue culture experiments, make sure to check us out at plantcelltechnology.com for all the products you need to get started. Use the code FP10 for 10% off your first purchase.